Hey everyone, Cass here, and today we check out another VR workout app on the Oculus Quest, but it works on PC VR too. If you have been following us for a while already, then you may know that I'm a fan of VR workouts. At the start of the lockdown in the Netherlands, I started to dive into workout apps and games available in the Matrix, and I've never stopped. I've honestly never been this active in my life before, so I'm extra grateful to have VR in my life during these times. This is why I think it's worth it to share those kind of things on this channel too. Today, HoloFit gave me a subscription to try it out, so we're gonna dive into their app. If you'd like to see more videos like this one, subscribe if you haven't yet, and stick around until the end of the video to hear my conclusion. And now, join me beyond reality. Let's start with an introduction. HoloFit by Holodia is a subscription-based VR app that puts you plus various home gym equipment inside a virtual environment. So it looks and feels like you're running in the game when you're on a cross trainer, for example, or that you're actually rowing a boat if you're on a rowing machine. On top of that, HoloFit gamifies your workouts to keep things fun and help you stay motivated. It also keeps statistics to show you how you're doing. What makes this one different from the last similar app we checked out is that HoloFit works for multiple exercise equipment. It works with rowing machines, exercise bikes, ellipticals, or cross trainers and steppers. For 10 euros a month or 108 euros per year, you get access to all HoloFit apps, and you can try it in the 7 days trial too. You do need your own exercise equipment and VR headset. HoloFit is compatible with many headsets like the Oculus Quest, Oculus Rift, and HTC Vive headsets. You can use one subscription on multiple headsets. All indoor fitness machines with the Fitness Machine Service Bluetooth protocol, in short FTMS, work with HoloFit. But even if you don't have FTMS on your machine, then you can get a separate sensor to make it work. You can get one with your subscription for a one-time fee of 35 euros, or you can buy a compatible one somewhere else. A list with compatible sensors can be found on Holodia's website. You can also use the app without a fitness machine, but more on this later. For this video, I used the Oculus Quest in combination with this cross trainer, and since this one doesn't have built-in Bluetooth, I needed a separate add-on to make it work. This is a cadence sensor, which is a high sensitive sensor that can track rotations per minute. This data is sent to the headset to simulate the movement and speed inside the virtual environment. This needs to be attached on a spinning part of the fitness machine. I have it placed on this rotating wheel because the sensor needs to be rotating for it to work, so I used double-sided tape and put it on the wheel. This can be different per machine though. So after this, the last thing to do is software setup. You can get a subscription from the HoloFit website, and from there you can find the needed software and guides. For the Oculus Quest, the HoloFit app is currently only available on SideQuest. Download and install it from there. If you don't know how to sideload, you can check out my guide on it. When you launch the app for the first time on your Quest, you will get a 5-digit number that you need to register on your account on the website. We're almost done. Now we got to connect the Quest to the cadence sensor. This can be done by going to the settings in the app and looking for it. Make sure it's on by moving on the machine for like 10 seconds, and once you see that it receives data, that you're ready to go. The last thing you might want to check is if the sensor is set on the right type of machine you are on. This can be selected in the Bluetooth menu up here. As I'm on a cross trainer, I chose elliptical. This changes the device you're on when you're in a workout, which makes it feel more immersive. Once done, you're ready to get sweating. HoloFit also comes with an app that you can install on your phone, which is optional, but it shows a summary of your workout statistics. You get a tab with ranks, a tab with statistics per workout that you've done, and you can find people around the world who are using HoloFit. It can be nice. So let's move on to gameplay. But before we move on, don't forget to leave a like for support. So, in the app, navigation is done with your gaze, so no need for controllers. The app has a single player and multiplayer mode. In multiplayer mode, you can play locally or online. The single player mode has 4 game types: explore, time attack, race, and cardio goals. I'll show and explain each game type in a bit, but I wanted to show you these choices first because they are the same. Each game type has 5 difficulties, from very easy to very hard. The harder the difficulty, the more intense the workout will be. The game also shows a nice little graph to show you where it might bring your heart rate. After selecting a difficulty, you can choose the workout duration, and after that you get to pick an environment. The single player mode has 11 environments to choose from, which differs from cities you might recognize like San Francisco or Paris, but also fantasy environments like Babylon or space. So let's talk about the different game types now. This is Time Attack, which is a mode where you try to beat your own or other's score, which is the distance passed over a specific time after the initial session has been recorded. If you're looking for a sprint, this is a suitable mode. Then there is Race, which lets you improve your performance by racing AI competitors that are designed to challenge you just enough. This works pretty motivating if you see AI going faster than you. Then we have Cardio Goals, which is my favorite mode as it is a guided type of training for different workouts. You can choose from cardio, fat burn, interval training, or the more recently added high intensity interval training. The accompanying graphs will show you what will happen during these modes, and this mode is a little different from the others as you will see goals in your environment that looks like a giant speedometer. These meters will tell you whether you should go faster or slower. The last mode is Explore, which is the most casual mode as you can decide your own speed here as you explore the environment. In this mode, there are collectibles to be found with your gaze, and these collectibles can later be found in the HoloFit app on your phone. Throughout the workouts, you also gain achievements like total burned calories or total distance ran. The multiplayer mode is just like the single player racing mode, except it has fewer environments, only 5. This mode can be pretty motivating though to get you to go harder. HoloFit organizes multiplayer events too, which helps as well. You can also use local multiplayer modes, which you could use if you have multiple machines or if you plan on using this at your gym. Last mode to talk about was added just this week, which is called Freestyle. This mode doesn't require an exercise machine, as you can just use your controllers. In this mode, you have all the same game types, but you can choose between 3 movement styles. The run style speaks for itself. It has you standing and making running movements with your arms and legs if you want to move forward. According to Holodia, this movement will activate your arm and shoulder muscles as well as your calves. Cycle has you sitting on the floor and cycling with your arms, which according to Holodia can be good for your shoulders, chest and triceps. Row has you sitting on the floor and doing rowing movements while doing something like sit-ups. I'm not a big fan of this mode, but I do like the row movement as it feels like I'm doing sit-ups and really working my core and stomach muscles, which doesn't happen often in other VR apps. So that covers most of what the app has to offer, and man, what a workout was that recording this. But so far I'm enjoying it. As with any app, it can be all good of course. HoloFit could use a graphical upgrade and the animations could use some work to make it all prettier and more immersive. The app could be more optimized too as loading times can be pretty long. And using the Quest, I had a few crashes. I guess that hand tracking caused it when it automatically enables, as I left my controller somewhere else, so I turned all the enable for hand tracking off, and that seems to have solved it. But overall, the app's features do feel like they have been thought through. After the initial setup, it's effortless to get started. Especially the guided workout mode Cardio Goals is motivating and gets me pushing harder than I usually would without HoloFit. Even though the environments could use some work, it suffices as it can distract me enough from the workout as I find it fun to look around to see what's happening. This is distraction in a good way because the goals keep me at the right speed, but I just forget I'm working out for a bit and time passes by faster. As I've said before in previous videos, gamification elements are what keeps me motivated, so things like goals and achievements help with that for me. These are things that HoloFit has to offer, so if you are like me, then this might be something for you too. I do think I could get bored after a couple of months with the environments, especially since you're running the same thing over and over. So I would love to see something like procedurally generated environments to keep things diverse each time. But developers have said that they add new updates every month. To put things into perspective, they've told us that since the end of last year, they've released the workout modes Race and Online Multiplayer and 4 new environments, an extra cardio option as well as functional updates and wider compatibility. So to conclude, I see myself using HoloFit for a while, but in combination with other VR games throughout the week to keep it diverse. If you're interested, I will put a link below. For those who are on a budget, you can also find a lot of VR games that can get you moving too at a more affordable price. Check out this playlist with some more tips. Just keep in mind that most of these games are not designed with workouts in mind. So to get a better workout, I do think apps like HoloFit are a good option for that. So, do you have an exercise machine at home? If so, which one, and would you get HoloFit for it? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. And one last thing for those who want to know how I keep sweat off my headset, I recommend checking out VRCover's new silicone covers, which is this one. It's not perfect as this nose cap thing keeps coming off, but it works very well for workouts. I'm also a fan of the leather VR covers that they have, which is the one I use regularly for workouts. I will put the link of all this in the description down below. And I want to thank you for watching once again. Seriously guys, we can't do all of this without all of you. So much love from us. And a special thanks goes to our patrons and right hand patron Backzone VR. Supporting us by checking out this YouTube channel. And as always, VR on.